Mr. Julius came to the Mount Zion Church of All Nations with a crucial pain due to pile as prescribed by the doctor. After all struggle to get out of this pain, all his efforts proved abortive. There is no problem Jesus cannot solve, neither there is any sickness he cannot heal. He is the doctor of all doctors. Let's listen to what he has to say concerning his situation.
So, brother, you're welcome in Mount Zion Church of All Nations. Could you please tell us your name, your age, and where you're coming from?
Thank you, brother. Good morning.
Morning.
My name is our friend Pedro's. I'm from Bonakama. I'm a driver from Teka.
And your age?
My age 32 years.
Okay, so brother, could you please tell us what brought you to the Mount Zion Church of All Nations?
What brought me in the Mount Zion Church? It's an illness which I've been to the hospital for long. No way. I lost my head is pie. I've been for traditional people, no way. I decided really to come here to give all my life to Christ. If it is here, I will die. God will show you here. If today, I will be fine. God will decide everything here. That's why I've come here today.
Okay. So, brother, for how long has this been disturbing you now?
This has been disturbing me. Over 2 months now, of course. It's been almost 2 months now. The disturbing that 2 months. Was only pain a little bit. Been to Bingo. After all the lab tests, they say typhoid. I took all the typhoid medicine in Norway. I've been to that government hospital in Three Corner. I've been there. All type of lab tests have made it. The man said I have not seen anything. But it's all wound in my anus. They gave me drugs, gave me injection. I'm taking them no way. I've been to General Hospital. I've been in General Hospital for long. I was admitted. It was on Thursday. I refused to be there again. I decided to discharge myself alone. Oh, my brother.
Okay, so brother, you have gone to so many hospitals, no avail.
No way.
I've given you drugs also, no avail.
I haven't been to Ekumbi. For traditional. That is to cure the pie. That is pie. Instead from the pains of pie, now I'm feeling different system now. My anus swell.
Okay, so when you went to the hospital, what did the doctor say?
In the hospital, General Hospital, they made all type of lab tests, all negative.
Okay. And so, brother, could you please tell us how this been disturbing your daily activities?
Yes, brother, if I don't go to work, my family will not fit. I will not be able to pay a house rent. And now, I'm not stranded.
Okay, sir, we are seeing a stick on your hand. So could you please tell us what's the use of the stick?
The stick is to support me because I cannot stand straight.
Okay.
Support me. I cannot stand straight.
So you are telling us that even to sit, you cannot sit?
No way. The message.
Okay, so now that you are here in Mount Zion Church of All Nations, what do you want God to do for you?
Hi, my brother. I want God to do all the best to heal me.
Amen.
Because I've seen that there's no way except the God will put his hand there. Holy God.
Indeed, being said by the man of God that if you have tried hospital, try all drugs, if it did not seem to move, you should come to God because God is the final man. He's the only one that can set us free, heal us, and deliver us. So, brother, we thank you and we also pray that the Almighty God is going to heal you and will leave you here by faith. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, brother, could you please, before we go, you show us the pie?
Even though we cannot see clearly, but you cannot open it now.
No way.
Okay.
But thank God, I will believe that by His grace, you have come to the right place, and God is what your brother is facing. You tell us your name and just explain a little bit of it.
I'm Adam Michael. Julius is my junior brother. I wasn't in town because I being a medical personnel, and again, I work with one international NGO, which makes me frequently go out of town, coming back at times 2-3 days. I just received a call that was last week that he's not feeling fine, and last 2 weeks that he's not feeling fine, and he has been to the hospital and some drugs being prescribed. So I came, some of the drugs I'm the one who even administered. And when I discovered that I don't tumor see differences, we had to go to the general hospital, because me being a medical personnel, I know some of the differences. So I took him to the general hospital. There, he consulted a specialist and a surgeon, which we didn't see any differences. So after we got the information that it was PI, we decided to see one traditional doctor who is good for. But after being there for a while, I would discover that the pain is consistently being so serious, and there is swelling on his buttocks. So we decide that better he should see the face of God. Yeah, because nothing is above God. Nothing is above God. I remember when I was in this church some months back, when my wife had a problem, many temptation came, and the man of God said, the day I will cross the water, that is leaving Fiango, Kukusala, leaving Fiango, and cross Kumbawata and start staying in Boya Road, I will see differences. And I discovered it, and when I crossed, I saw that what the man of God said was true. Yeah, because we have so many encounters when we're this way, and I believe the man of God that only God alone who have inspired him will heal my junior brother. And I believe the power of Jesus Christ in Mount Zion.
Amen.
That is why we are here today.
Okay, thank you, brother. So thank God for that and for your belief. And the Bible says, when you believe, God is going to set you free.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
What you are watching now is the Mount Zion Church of All Nations Sunday prayer line, when Prophet Benjamin moved among them, ministering the lightning water in Jesus' name. Among the people on the prayer line was Mr. Julius. Let's see how he got his healing by the power of the Holy Spirit.
That you got the first to administer the lightning water.
Amen.
I've been for 4 years without talking about it, about water. Believe Jesus, we are not believing the meter. The bottle and the water, they are material. But it came through spirit. So you must believe in Jesus, not the thing. Amen? So I'm not the healer, I'm not the deliverer. Jesus Christ is a healer, Jesus Christ is a deliverer. Check yourself, the way you are, so that the moment heaven could say, I should put it on your body, you will know something is happening to you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let me attend to your hand. I'm praying my heart. Amen.
Amen.
I also knew what? I'm praying in my heart. Amen?
Amen.
I'm not a healer. Jesus Christ is there. He's a healer. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Brother, how are you now? Are you sure you're fine? Yeah, you say you're fine, but you're working with your stick now. Why not? One month today. You don't know what happened to you?
I was making.
You said nothing. Because what is living there like power? It's not what the devil is showing us. It's not even power. And you believe just can heal you now? You believe that?
Okay.
This is a medium they want to use to deliver you, to free you, to bless you for the salvation of your soul. You will receive your healing and your deliverance not because you are under pain, but because it was destined that they will deliver you today. It was destined that you will pass through this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth. Come here. You are free.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, my God.
Now, brother, you see, he was not sitting, but now go and ask him now. Is I see the pain are going? Brother? Is I see the pain are just going? They're just going. See, he cannot sit. He cannot stand up and sit. Look the way he's now sitting alone. You see this sister?
He has been unable to sit for more than 10 days now.
Huh?
He has only been lying.
You see better? You see
this? Hey. Amen. Praise God.
Please stay here. I'm putting here. Come. You see the reaction here? For the vision. Amen.
Yeah.
He said, lightning water means, as he declared in the beginning, that let there be light.
Amen.
Light appear. That means free. Amen. Amen. He declared that let there be light, and that means free, light established. So that's how the moment you receive it, that means it's free in your life, and then you are receiving your healing. In Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Is your husband? Okay, you have not been sitting like this now. For how long now?
More than 10 years.
10
days.
I mean 10 days.
Yes.
Listen. Somebody cannot sit like this. Only... Brother, how are you now? Yes. In true what? True, huh? Maybe it is not me that I pray for him. Then God has used this medium. Brother, what are you saying? Why are you working here today?
I would say I'm a bit confused because I know what he has passed through, being a medical personnel from one hospital to the other. I know what we have done all necessary lab tests, nothing been seen. Let's say for the past 10 to about 18 days, he has just been lying, unable to do anything, unable to move. Maybe yesterday when we came here, just the man of God, he was lying on the bench. He was unable to move, that's why we couldn't come inside with him. But by the power of the administration of the life and water, I have seen the miracle of Jesus Christ.
We are on peace. But I want you to say, concerning the way you came yesterday and the way you came this morning, What can you really say to us? Because there's someone inside of you who is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. This is not the one that heal you. Don't go and say what other danger. It is Jesus Christ that passed through this medium as I give my message today that not the medium, but God's Spirit is what that heals you now. What can you not say? What happened to you yesterday and today morning before the vision of this life in your water, brother? Your name? What's happening to your man? Come. Okay, there's one there now. You want to become a new way. So they said, what are you holding? Give me, say, what drops me water? Say, Mr. Queen, okay, what's your name? What is your name?
My name is Jessica Julius.
Amen! Okay, you came here yesterday with your family members and the pain and everything. You came here this morning. What happened? What are you going to say after the mission of the life in the water?
Well, I came here yesterday. There was no way to recognize myself. Well, when I started to get myself, it was his ushers. He take the two men outside. Twice myself. I kept on showing you there was no way people this morning. There was no way even to get this morning. Because fighting this morning, God will not be able to get the things of feeling. But now, the one thing I'm going on, I say I thank God very much.
The deliverance, the deliverance you need to meet is permanent, just an affliction. It's for us to demonstrate, God will demonstrate His power, that He can use any medium. He has been for pain for 18 days, 10 days. It was not by own strength. Like the brother earlier said, he's a medical personnel. He said that he is not confused. Because what? This medium, we do not go anywhere. It is natural offer. The bottle is for your company. The water is God give. But it is still the same God that has still affect the container and the content to perform the act. See the brother today. And this is God also kept this day so that a medical person should be in this testimony for this scientific miracle. To tell you God that when something is beyond medical, they are stoned to curse. And the only person that can broke that case is who?
Jesus!
It's calling him alone. If you ask anybody, I pray for them. The woman I speak like this, trap on your body. Yeah, it's the wedding herself. It's like when you were inside an aunt. So, brother, you go and rest. Very miraculous. Next week, Sunday, you will come back with your leg. You come and share your testimony.
Yes,
you are free.
Thank you, Jesus. We thank Jesus for the miracle. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my brother.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. That's all we're going to walk now. Since our many days, the night is going. Before going back home, strong.
A few weeks later, Mr. Julius came back to the Mount Zion Church of All Nations with his families to testify to the goodness of God in their lives. Remember, only God can give a permanent solution in every situation. Let's listen to their wonderful testimony.